little bit about our mission here on the Listening Room stage. So Song Suffragettes was founded about 10 years ago. Actually, we just had our 10-year anniversary. It was a huge shebang, super, super cool. But it was founded with the idea in mind of promoting more females in country music, as well as just Nashville's music scene in general and beyond. Women are greatly underrepresented by country radio in particular, and record labels. Last year, for example, the number of solo females represented on country radio was only 15%. And if you're a fan of 90s country, which is having a huge moment right now, you know the ladies of the 90s were everything, okay? So Song Suffragettes is a community of female singer-songwriters, and we bring you the best of the best music here every Monday. We now have two shows every Monday, 6 and 8 o'clock, y'all. It is just such a blast. Thank you guys for letting us do that. And since it started, over 400 women have played Song Suffragettes here on this stage, with over 40 of us going on to receive record deals, and over 60 have landed publishing deals. So thank you for helping us give female singer-songwriters a platform in this town. Thank you to The Listening Room for hosting us. This is just such a beautiful room. We're so lucky to be here. And we're so lucky to have you guys here listening and supporting us here in this room, as well as online. Hello, my online friends. Thank you guys for tuning in. So, that's a little bit of housekeeping here for Song Suffragettes. Just a couple more things before we go ahead and introduce these ladies up here. Tips, we do take tips for the show. If you like what you hear, you can send it through. We've got some screens rolling on the sides. It helps us get out of the parking lot at the end of the night. All very good things, okay? Covers our drink tabs and all that good stuff, and we really appreciate it. Helps us chase our dreams here in Nashville. As well as there is social media, not only for Song Suffragettes, but for every one of these fine ladies up here. So make sure if you're liking what you're hearing, you guys follow us, and you can keep up to date with all the new music, all the new events, all that good stuff, shows, all that type of thing. And merch. There is some Song Suffragettes merch out in the lobby after the show. A few of us will be coming to hang out there and say hi, so please come say hi to us. We would love to meet you and thank you personally for being here tonight. And you can pick up some Song Suffragettes merch to say you were here in person. Does that sound good so far? Are we good? All right. Making sure I'm not talking too fast. All right, y'all. Well, it's my pleasure to introduce these beautiful ladies up here on this stage. All the way on my right, our resident badass, Miss Mia Morris. Give it up for Mia, y'all. I was very excited to see that Mia went back to her brunette roots today. Yes, loving this. Loving this. She said the bleach was getting to her brain. Yeah. I think maybe I said that, but she agreed. All right, y'all. Next to her, we have Miss Abby Cates. Directly on my right, Miss Sasha McVeigh. Give it up. Oh, on my left over here, Brailey Lenderman. Give it up. And in our newbie chair, as we so lovingly call it, y'all give it up for CashK. It's her very first song, Suffragettes. Whew. Well, now the scary part's over. We can let the music begin, y'all. Thank you so much for being here. Again, my name's Haley Mae Campbell, and Miss Abby Cates is going to take it away and kick us off.
Hey,
y'all. Give it up.
Hello. Once again, I am Abby Cates. I haven't been here in a while, so good to be back. I'm going to start us off with a little bit of some sad vibes, if that's okay, the listening room tonight. This is a song about not knowing when to stop wanting things that are bad for you, if ever of any. Yes, if anyone has experienced that, this is about that. So this is called The Leash, and it's unreleased. So. I'm actually going to change where my capo is. That's one thing about me. I never know where my capo needs to be.
I'll pull her back off the road.
Thank you.
Perfectly describes my dog. I know that there's a much deeper meaning to that song, but I have a Chihuahua crossed with a dachshund, and from the time that he was a puppy, he thought it was hysterical to, you know, chase cars and try and go in between the wheels, and I'm freaking out, and he's like, look, Mom, so fun. I'm like, yeah, really fun. Well, my name is Sasha McVeigh. I am the resident British redneck of this writer's round this evening. I actually got my American citizenship in October last year as well, which was a long time coming, and I joke now that, you know, the worst thing that could happen to me is I can get thrown in jail, but at least I can't get deported and sent back to England. So, you know, small wins, people. But I've always loved country music. I grew up listening to it with my dad, and one of the funny things when I started coming here to Nashville was I would take meetings with people, and, you know, they'd say to me, how on earth can a British girl, you know, who grew up in England be country? Like, this doesn't make any sense. And I kind of always rationalized it with the fact that being country isn't really a specific location. It's kind of how you were raised and how you were brought up. And I was brought up in the middle of nowhere, surrounded by farms and farming communities, and grew up very, very simply. And I wanted to kind of write this song to give a bit of a middle finger to some of the people here in Nashville that told me that a British girl can't be country. I'm a bit of a glutton for punishment in terms of getting myself into trouble. So this song's called Black Label, and it goes like this.
Got an SUV, circa 96. My guy's in the shotgun, cause he don't drive stick. I'm not trying to get hitched, I drive one. Not trying to get rich, but I get it done. Bought a house with some land down by the creek. Got the porch screen doors and the kitchen sink. Not trying to show off, but I'll show ya that I've got it all, and I don't need much. Born east of the city, I was born on the right side. Wouldn't trade these hills for a high rise. Don't drive a Mercedes, not tripping in diamonds. Just need a dime in the jukebox for a good time. Champagne, wine off the table. I'm not black tie, black label. When life's 9 to 5, I've got your 6. When you're hung out to dry, I've got your fix. I'm not living halfway, I'm all in. Yeah, that's not gonna change. And I promise, born east of the city, I was born on the right side. Wouldn't trade. Just a little more fire in my glass. Hey, born east of the city, I was born on the right side. Wouldn't trade these hills for a high rise. Don't drive a Mercedes, not dripping in diamonds. Just need a dime in the jukebox for a good time. Midnight, townies all clearing out. Tonight it's a homegrown crowd, so take a champagne. Why?
Nashville. Y'all feeling good so far? All right. Well, I just released a brand new single a couple weeks ago, and I'm super, super excited about it because, to let you in on a secret, it's going to be the first single off of my upcoming debut album, which I'm really, really excited about. It's a pretty psychotic thing to do as an independent artist, but I guess I'm pretty psychotic, so I will be putting out a full record early next year, but I'm going to be putting out tons of songs from it this year. And when I was thinking about, you know, what to put out first from such a daunting project, I wasn't really sure until I wrote this song with a couple of my good friends, Lydia Dahl, Zachary Mano, and Gloria Anderson here in town. And I felt like we just captured the essence and the sonic just value of what I was trying to do and the energy that I was trying to bring to my style of country music. This is actually a really fun round, I'm realizing, because we've got a lot of Euro girlies up here. I got my dual citizenship. I'm also an Irish citizen now. So y'all come to us, I don't know, for fish and chips and all the things after the show. But once we wrote this song, I just knew that this was exactly what I wanted to say first from the top of a record. So I hope you guys like this one. It's all about considering yourself the luckiest girl in the world. It's called Lucky Girl. It goes like this. Woke up this morning to the sunlight on my face. Even when the weatherman swore on thunderstorm and rain. Now I'm driving with the windows down. I caught every green light on my street. Reached in my pocket, found an old $10 bill. So I walked in the coffee shop because I had some time to kill. When I got up to the counter, turned out the guy before had paid for me. How sweet. I guess you could say I'm on a lucky streak. So even if my day starts getting worse, I know that my table's bound to turn. Cause I'm always looking for a silver lining. Even if it's kinda hard to find it, it all works out for me. Cause I'm a lucky girl.
I'm like, my mouth is watering because I'm just watching this guy eat a hamburger. And I can like smell it and it smells so good. Are you enjoying it? No.
That I'm would be a first, I think, on the song Suffragettes.
Somebody
stage.
Just bring it, instead yeah, of a shot, so. Bring a hamburger.
Yeah,
up here.
I think so.
I would love that. I would love a hamburger with cheese.
She doesn't want any shots, guys. But the rest of us, I don't know.
Manifest. One time I was playing Old Red and somebody dead ass brought an entire plate of nachos for me because I'd been talking about them. So it's doable.
Dreams come true, guys. Dreams come true all the time here in Nashville, Tennessee. What can I say?
Actually, more than a burger, I'd love tips. So if you guys want to tip us, though, we'll take that too. And then I'll go buy a burger. I normally start with like a more like upbeat song. You know, if you want to get wild, don't ever come to me. You're going to get mild because I'm not going to make it like fun songs, you know? But I get a lot of inspiration from books I read. Is anybody else like a big reader?
Real. So anybody? Real.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Okay, like smutty books.
Yes.
We love those.
We have one really confident person, and the rest of y'all are liars, so I don't know.
Yeah, we all know what you're reading. Anyways, I get a lot of inspiration from, like, different quotes in books. There's just some great, great stuff in them. And I can't tell you which book I got this from, but there was a quote where this guy had left this girl, and she was like, she saw him freaking everywhere. And he's gone, but he's everywhere. And she was like, it's like he's everywhere and nowhere at once. And I hate it. Anyways, so I took that to a writing session with Sam Blasco, who, if I ever want to get like a song done, I just call Sam, and Sam's like, in 2 hours, we're done. So this is called Everywhere Nowhere at Once. It's not released. And that's all I have to say yet. Yeah, oh, listen, I have so much coming out. I'm backed up, y'all, music-wise. Anyways, here we go.
I found you student at the in between the seats. It's probably been there for years. Collecting up dust and trying to find the wrong time for you to show up and appear. Like when I cleaned out my closet and I found your shirt. Your smell was still on it. God, did it hurt? You said goodbye, but somehow you're still around. And I wanna move on, but it's like you won't let me. You're all in my mind and all over this city. Yeah, you left town, but your memory stays. Even in crowds, yeah, I still see your face. I'll be doing fine, but suddenly I'm coming undone. Cause it's just like you to be everywhere and nowhere. Even when we moved into a new two-bedroom, it never felt like a home. You would get high and drunk at some time when I was getting used to being alone. And I wanna move on, but it's like it won't let me. You're all in my mind and all over this city. Yeah, you left town, but your memory stays. Doing fine, but suddenly I'm coming undone. Cause it's just like you to be everywhere and nowhere at once. Yeah, everywhere and nowhere, yeah. Wish I said I don't care, but damn, babe, you never play fair. You pay. And I wanna move on, but it's like you won't let me. You're all in my mind and all over the city. Yeah, you left town, but your memory stays. Even in crowds, yeah, I see your damn face. I'll be doing fine, but suddenly I'm coming undone. Cause it's just like you to be everywhere and nowhere.
Thank you.
Yeah,
girl.
You're such a hype girl. We love girls, girls.
Hi, everybody.
I would like a tip more. So, whatever that burger costs, just put it in the dip jar.
Hi, everyone. My name's CashK. Thank you guys for being here. This is my first time at the listening room ever, and it's really exciting. I've seen this writer's round. Like, I've been in Nashville for 4 years. I went to Belmont University and just graduated last August. So I've seen this writer's round all over the place, and it's kind of legendary, and it's a real honor to be here. So thank you guys so much for having me. I typically sing, like, R&B music, and so I love that I am allowed this space up here and get to, like, show that Nashville is not just country music and that there's more out there and more going on. So yeah, this first song that we're gonna do, and this is Sam, by the way. Thank you, Sam, for playing with me. This first song that we're gonna do, I wrote back in, I guess it was my sophomore year, and it's basically about, I was in a relationship and it was long distance, and all the time he would just, like, blame me for stuff and, like, be super insecure and make me feel really unappreciated, and so this sort of came out of that. If you ever heard me say I'm sorry, then you must have caught me at the wrong time. I don't want apologizing, boy, I memorized all your lines. I knew you would do this, why I didn't want to get involved. Now I'm going through it, I do nothing wrong. You got me so messed up. When I give you all my love, and I'm tired of this feeling, you don't appreciate me. My love has no ceiling, but you're finding all these ways to break it. Oh. Yeah, you're finding all these ways to break it. Whenever we talk, I wonder what you heard. Cause you always find a way to go in. Switch up my words, you'll never hear a thing I say. That's why we've been in this fight all day. You say you can't read my mind. Boy, get off my line. Cause you got me so messed up. When I give you all my love, and I'm tired of this feeling, you don't appreciate me. My love has no ceiling, but you're finding all these ways to break it.
Fantastic. Y'all, we feeling good, Nashville. We feeling good. Y'all are pretty rowdy for a 6 o'clock crowd, I'm not going to lie. I like it. I like the energy. I like it. I like it. Keep bringing it, y'all. We got another round coming for you right now, Miss Abby.
Yes. I mean, she better sing. Can we give it up, like, one more time?
Thank you.
This next song, I love to play. I love being here because you can test out some new songs. And this is a song that I wrote about someone not being who you want them to be. When you're like dating someone, you're like, you are close, but not it, you know? Which is sounds mean to say actually out loud. When I just said it, that sounded mean. But yeah, this is a song kind of talking about how you're grateful to have been loved by someone, but like, thank you next, kind of, you know? Y'all are with me? Okay. Thank you. Okay. What is this called? I just wrote it. Let me think. Soft Skin, I think, is what I called it. Whatever. This is, again, I'm Abby Cates. This is an unreleased song. yeah, okay. You are just like her, soft skin. You were just like her, dancing in the cool air. Your hips, you were just like her, singing me songs in your room, driving out under the moon, trying out feelings on you, thinking they fit so well before I found myself all alone. Realize what I'd always known. We were honest, but it wasn't quite true. Perfect, but it wasn't quite you. Happy, hold on. Happy that you love me, but I'm glad you're gone. Happy that you love me, but I'm glad you're gone. I'm happy that you love me, but I'm glad that you're gone.
I think I'm going to do the same thing and play a new song. Listen, folks, if it's not good, at least it can be funny. You know, it's like, that's what my mom always used to say. She's like, if it's not going to be good, like, at least make it comical and people won't care.
Real, so real.
I always used to be, when I first, I've been coming to Nashville since 2012, before I finally got my green card in 2017. And it's so funny for me to look back at, like, old videos where I would be so absolutely petrified to play a song, you know, that I'd like never done before. That was like the most colossal thing that I could possibly do, was to play a song for the first time in front of people. And I play a lot on Lower Broadway to kind of pay the bills and all that. And you really do have to just roll with the punches. Like, if somebody comes up to you and is like, hey, $100, can you play this song? You don't really want to say no. So you're like, sure, I can do that. The only time it's failed miserably is I had had a couple of shots of whiskey and I was very confident that I could get through Bohemian Rhapsody by myself. Freddie Mercury, I apologize profusely. It was not good, and it wasn't funny. It was just bad. Well, here's another one for my sins. Has anyone ever been going out with somebody and then you end up realizing you actually like somebody else, or is that just me? Some of y'all are lying, I know. I wrote this song with a really good friend of mine, Joe Barron, and he basically knows everything about me and will take many things to the grave. But this song's called Guilty and it's brand new, and yeah, if you've ever been dating someone and then you realize you like somebody else, this is for you.
You said I love you, but I didn't say it back. You know I like you, but boy, just not like that. So go and run my name all over town. Do your best to drag me down. In the end, the jury's out. Say I'm guilty for walking away, but all the red flags waving gave me a green light. I couldn't stay. You say you hate me 'cause I found somebody. But I saw the signs. You say I'm heartless just for following mine. So you can pay me like a dirty cheat, 'cause I wash my hands of you and me. You play the victim perfectly. Oh, I guess I'm guilty of walking. Say you hate me 'cause I found somebody new. Well, I guess I'm guilty of choosing me over you. Yeah, I guess I'm guilty of choosing me over you. I guess I'm guilty, so throw the cuffs on me. I guess I'm guilty, lock me up and throw away the key. Oh boy, I'm guilty of walking away, but all those red flags waving gave me a green light and I couldn't stay. You say you hate me 'cause I found somebody. Choosing me or you, yeah, I guess I'm guilty of choosing me over you, yeah.
Thank you so much.
I love it. Well, this next song, I normally start rounds with this song, but I wanted to make sure, I know it's an earlier show, I was like, okay, I have to make sure that you guys are ready for like a little sing-along part. You've proven to me very early on that you are ready for that, so I do have high expectations, I just want to let you know. But if anybody out there has ever wondered how country music was created, this song is for you. It's called Eighth Day. I hope you like it.
Well, he was off to a pretty good start when he separated light from dark. Needed somewhere to hang the sun, so he made the sky. And I bet he didn't get much sleep the day he made all seven seas. took a break after bringing you and me to life. Then he took a banjo, a little bit of fiddle. He took a 4x4, put it out in the middle of nowhere. With the back roads lead right to the stars. Threw in some whiskey and a few broken hearts. Had a hole in an old oak tree. Then he spoke the truth of a 6 gold strings. No doubt that he knew what he was doing. On the 8th day, God made country music. He sent a few angels down to earth, opened the doors to a neon church. He kicked the devil out of heaven, that's how he wound up in Georgia. True story, he took every little thing that we need to know, stuck it in an FM radio. So the next time you turn it up, thank the good Lord above. Cause he took a banjo, a little bit of fiddle, he took a few broken hearts. Got a hole in an old oak tree. Then he spoke the truth of his 6 gold strings. No doubt that he knew what he was doing. On the 8th day, God made country music. Yeah. He made country music.
All right, Nashville. I know you're ready for it. I know we're ready down here in the front. Okay. So I'm going to sing it to you, and you sing it back to me, ladies. Feel free to help me out, all right? It goes like this. Ready? Hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, oh. That's it, y'all. Super easy. Come on. Hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, oh. Oh, a little louder now. You got it. Come on. Hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, oh. Just one.
It comes out on May 24th. It's going to be my next single. So thank y'all so much for letting me play it.
Doesn't that confuse you why, like, a bunch of women aren't signed? Isn't that, like, nuts to you guys? Like, why isn't that on the radio? I mean, I guess it's not released yet. Yeah. Ma'am.
I think that'd be a pretty dope first country radio single. You'll get a forehead kiss. So you never know.
Well, now that you guys are all happy. Who wants to be sad? Yeah? Okay, cool. Hey. Oh no, this is like about to take a big turn.
It's good. We're here for it.
Hallelujah.
This is a twisting, turning kind of show, okay?
Oh my gosh, you guys, this is what a manic episode feels like. Alrighty. Hey. So 2 years back, I wasn't going to play this, but then I was like, well, I need to because it's the 2-year anniversary. Anyways, so when I came to Nashville almost 10 years ago, it's a 10-year town. Nothing's happened for me yet, so work on it. But I was, like, deep in country music. I was signed with this manager, and it was lights and shows, and it was great, whatever. And then I was like, I'm kind of unhappy. And I realized, you know, I think it's because everybody's telling me what to write and what to do, and that kind of makes me sad, and I don't like that. Anyways, so back in 2021, I got COVID, and it was horrible, and I had to have a heart surgery over it. And during that, I'm good, guys. She's beating. It wasn't, like, that big of a deal. I'm alive. That's why it wasn't a big deal. So I was like, I was just kind of alone during that time, besides like my hot husband. But I would tell him to raise his hand, but he's gonna be so sad. So that right there. Anyways, so yeah, so I was kind of wondering if I even wanted to do music anymore. I think we've all had that idea. I would say for me once a week. I don't know about you guys.
Yeah.
But when you're pouring your heart out like every day and you're just like trying so hard, we rely on people to listen and to like and to share, and nobody was doing that for me. And I think it's because I never released music that was really true to myself. So I had a lot of honest conversations with myself because I'm very self-aware. And anyways, I got with two girls, and we wrote this song called Honest Conversations. And this is just kind of like a little like moment where I say, you know, if you're kind of in a low area right now, therapy's great. you know, however you choose to heal is how you – don't do hard drugs. You know, let's not get into alcohol, but like, you know, medication that's monitored and therapy, singing, I don't know. Whatever you need to do to heal is a big deal. And I'm really glad I didn't give up because I've gotten to do a lot of really cool things since then. I've gotten to do The Voice, and I got to play the Bluebird for the first time, and I've released so much music. In fact, if you guys are here May 2nd, come find me at the Bluebird. I've gotten to do a lot of really cool things, and I'm really glad I didn't give up. But
we're really glad too.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, guys, music's hard. Yeah. So this is called Honest Conversations, and it's out, so you guys can go stream it for me. And that gets me like not even half of a penny, so if you guys want to tip too, you can.
I think it's time we had a talk, one that we've been putting off for some time now. I know that this is getting hard, but go ahead, let down your guard. It's just you and me right now. Cause if I was self-aware like I say I am, then maybe this would get easier. But damn, I'm having honest conversations about how much time that I've been wasting, living life for somebody else. And I'm having realizations that there's nothing wrong with changing and losing a part of myself. So I'm having never found my way back to you. Cause if I was self-aware like I say I am, then maybe this would get easier. But damn, I'm having honest conversations about how much time that time that I've been wasting, living life for some.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Okay, that was beautiful. Thank you for being so real and so open.
You're beautiful.
This next song that I'm going to be singing for you guys, I just wrote like 2 or 3 weeks ago. And it was like a concept that I made up in my head, as we so often do as songwriters, just trying to make up stories and stuff. So it's about, let's say you went to sleep next to someone that maybe you're in a relationship with, but what he laying next to you doesn't know is that you're going to sleep and you're dreaming about somebody else.
Yeah.
I know, crazy. So this one's called Dream Boy. I've been having trouble sleeping. I've been seeing you out the corner of my eye. Your voice is in my mind, night after night. I've been tossing, turning, token, burning, puffing on these trees. I've been messing around with other people, trying to get some peace. I can try, but no lie, no lie. You're in my dreams, boy. Can't get no release, boy. Can't try to find another man or another plan. Understand, I just can't give up giving the one that I feel for. My dream. Every time I close my eyes, I feel you closing in on me, and it's not right. Night after night, I've been wondering if we've ever met. I need your time. I would know a face like that in any life. What you do to me, now I know it's true to see. I can't hide, can't hide, can't hide, 'cause you're in my dreams, boy.
These incredible ladies up here, please give it up. Now, this is one of my very, very favorite parts of the show, and before I introduce it, I just want to say, I was just whispering to Sasha, I like love this crowd. I've played this show a bunch of times, and y'all have to be one of my favorite crowds. Y'all are so engaged and so excited, and we really, really appreciate it. I know a lot of us spend a lot of time in this town and other towns around the country playing other people's songs and playing covers, and it means a lot to us to be up here playing our own songs. So thank you for being so excited about it, because we are excited about it too. And thank you. And now to introduce one of my favorite parts of the show. I introduced her earlier, but our resident
badass, as I like to call her, Miss Mia Morris. It's like I would say she's gonna play a song for you, but like that doesn't really do it justice. So I'm gonna let her just explain what she's about to do. Y'all get up for Mia. Come on, give it up.
Thank you. She is right on. You guys have been an amazing crowd. Thank you for being here. Woo! Packing it out, too. Darn. Anyway, I used to do this a lot, but I haven't done it in a minute. We live stream every show, and I love the YouTubers that come on. They watch this show every Monday. So I asked them this week. I gave them three options of songs to pick from, and this is what they chose.
Okay, give the people what they want.
So shout out to the streamers. Love you guys.
Yes, we love our YouTube
crowd.
Yes,
we love them. But I'm a live looper, so I'm about to make a lot of noise. This song is called What the Hello.
Shut the door, then let my breath hum out of sight. It's been a while since my echo heard a reply. Empty never felt out of place. But something's changed now that I'm looking at your face. I don't wanna wait, no, this is insane.
So I just made a bass loop. She's about to come back in. Thank you. And I forgot to mention, is anyone from Atlanta in here? Yes?
Ooh, okay.
I'm playing your state on Friday at Smith's Old Bar in Georgia.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, if anyone, if you're from there, if you are going.
Rally the troops.
But Smith's Old Bar in Georgia.
Oh, it's in Atlanta, baby.
It's in
Atlanta. Oh, yeah. I played there in November. It's a great place.
Okay.
Great spot. Go check her out.
I know my states and I know my cities. This is the second verse.
Usually I know exactly what to say, but I guess an awkward smile is all I've got today. Because I don't want to wait. No, this is hello.
what the hello.
Mae Morris, everybody!
Thank you. Thank you so much.
To every single person around the room who I saw during that song going, same. You see now why it is my favorite part of the show, y'all. Give it up for Mia. She's here almost every single Monday.
Thank you so much.
Not only doing her own badass thing, but seriously getting up here with all of us who most of us, I'm just going to out us real quick. We don't send her these songs ahead of time. We're sitting back there in the green room like, what am I going to play? And Mia just does it on the fly. She's so incredibly talented. One more time for Mia, y'all.
Thank you.
And I like her better as a brunette. I'm sorry. I just do.
It's
y'all,
cheaper.
We have one more round for you guys. Are we feeling good still? Okay. All right, y'all. Abby, take it away.
It is so beyond rude to have to go after that. I cannot. Please. Okay. This is my last song. This is called Happy. And anyone a girl or woman?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Girls or women. Love y'all. This is about that, like being a girl, being a woman, and that experience that we all have. So, let me make sure I'm playing it right first, because that didn't work last time. Okay, this is called Happy. It's sort of about how maybe when you're younger in life, you try to make yourself smaller to seem more desirable, and then later it's like, I don't care, I want to be myself, you know? Anyone? Yep, okay. This is called Happy.
Picking my cuticles like I might find something inside them. Maybe a brand new category to identify me. What kind of girl am I? Pay $9.99 to find out. Hot, pretty, cute. What kind of fruit matches up with my hips? Never been calm a day in my life. Never collected in public. I will cry on buses and planes and Uber rides. But I'd rather be this than hate my insides. You used to be so nice. I've been stuck in a rage since puberty. Why? Are dumb. I hate pink and romantic movies. Yeah, I like basketball. It's so hot when you scream at the TV. Laughing at jokes at my expense with your hand on my knee. Guess what? Turns out other girls are exactly like me. You used to be so cool. I've been stuck in a rage since puberty. Why?
Where that was going to go is that you were going to say, like, this song's called Happy, but it's actually a really depressing song. I thought that was going to be the flip. Well, I'm going to play you kind of a song a little bit in that same vein. As you've probably already gathered, I'm a little bit of a hot mess. Does anybody else identify as a hot mess in this room? And certainly when I was growing up, I thought that everything I did had to be absolutely perfect, and I'm still a recovering perfectionist to this day. But I've kind of accepted that if people don't really like me the way that I am and the way that I present myself and the way that I come, they don't like the package, well, move on, I guess. You know, it doesn't really matter. You can't please everyone. You can't be everybody's cup of tea. So I wrote this song, basically kind of talking about some of the messes that I've managed to get myself into over the years. And if you relate to it, this song's for you as well. This song's called God Bless This Mess.
Dishes are piling up in the sink. Last night's dress is still on the floor. I already know what the neighbors think, but I left my give a damn at the door. I've got black mascara all over my face, and there's a French fry in my hair. McDonald's underwear's hanging on the flower vase. Not even sure how they made it there. Sorry, Dad. When I look back from my rocking chair, I go. Sure, I've burned some biscuits, fried my chicken. I've got a lot of batter left. I'll have some stories to tell, I guess. God bless this mess. I can shoot Jack back with the best of them, but a lady knows when to go. I might not have scratched off my millions yet, but I'll make good on what I owe. And I love my mama and I love my friends. I'd give the shirt change. I am who I am. If you don't like it, you can kiss my ass.
Sorry, listening group.
When I look back from my rocking chair, I don't want to have a single regret. I keep waiting on the day I see my glass half empty, but I ain't seen it yet. Sure, I burned some biscuits, fried my chicken. I've got a lot of batter left. I'll have some stories to tell, I guess. God bless this.
This is where somebody cooler than me would be able to do a guitar solo. That person is not me.
Time how grateful we all are to be up here. It's been such a pleasure to just play for you guys tonight some original music. So thank you so much for coming out and packing out this beautiful room. Thank you to the listening room and our amazing sound engineers up there. Y'all give it up for Marshall. We're so grateful to be here. Thank you to Song Suffragettes for having me come out and host. It's always so fun to get to hear all these amazing songs. And y'all don't forget, there's going to be merch out there in the lobby for Song Suffragettes. And follow us on all the socials and all the things. And a huge thank you to everyone who did send a tip through. It really goes a long way for us. We appreciate it so, so much. And it helps us live our dreams. So thank you for being here and supporting us. And I wasn't sure, actually, what song I was going to do for my third one. I've been doing, like, the same last song for, like, the last 3 years. And so I thought maybe I would change it up tonight. And but yes, I just, you actually inspired me to, because you said a phrase earlier that is literally the title of this song, and I was like, that's a sign. And then y'all are going over here with the girl power songs, and I just have to keep it going. I'm sorry, I have to keep it going. This is the right place to do it after all. So I thought I would play you guys a brand new one. This one's going to be out later this summer. But this is for anyone who maybe is not entirely sure quite yet. You will be by the end of the song what it is to be a girl's girl. This is for you. If you want to know where I got what I'm wearing, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you. If there's a creep at the bar that keeps staring, I'm gonna help ya, yeah, I'm gonna help ya. I'll tuck in your tag and I'll zip up your dress. If you're mad, go ahead, you can be mean for a sec. I don't know what's got time for my girls, girl, wherever you are in the world, girl. I'll be right there when you call me up. If you need to cry or wanna get drunk, I'll be your number one hype, girl. I got your back in a fight, girl. I'm always down, there ain't no doubt I'm a girl's girl. So, I'd never talk to your ex at a party. If he's dead to you, he's dead to me too. If you wanna take down the whole patriarchy, I'll get in the group chat, I'll get you an army. I'm an always got time for my girl's girl, wherever you are in the world, girl. I'll be right there when you call me up. If to cry, I wanna get drunk, I'll be your number one hype, girl. I got your back in a fight, girl. Round after round, I'm always down. There ain't no doubt I'm a girl's girl. No, there ain't no doubt I'm a girl's girl. Yeah. All right, Nashville. If for some reason you're not entirely 100% sure by now what this means, these next three lines, these are gonna be for you, okay? Are you ready? I'm gonna sum it right up for you. It goes like this. I'll give you the hair tie right off of my wrist. I'll turn it up if you play Taylor Swift. I'll gas you up when you're acting unhinged. If you're done, if you're pissed, I'll help you burn down a bridge. I'm an always got time for my girls, girl. Wherever you are in the world, girl. I'll be right there when you call me up. If you need to cry or wanna get drunk, I'll be your number one hype, girl. I got your back in a fight, girl. Round after round, I'm always down. There ain't no doubt I'm a girl's girl. No, there ain't no doubt I'm a girl's girl. Ooh, yeah. Thank you so much, Song Suffragettes. My name is Haley Mae Campbell. I appreciate it.
sorry. Listen, if you guys tip enough, I'll start writing happy songs. And I'm a happy person, like 90% of the time. I just take Zoloft. Cool. On the girl theme. Girl theme. God bless me. Cool. Okay. Take it in. First of all, wait, pause. You're from Atlanta?
Yeah.
What part?
Yeah.
I'm from Roswell. That's okay. We love College Park. We love the airport. Yeah. We love getting places. I love College Park. Also, go Braves. But not Georgia. So, last year... Was it even last year? I feel like time isn't even real anymore. we're in April. I know. So, was it last year? I don't know why I'm going to look at Maddie. I feel like it was last year. Maddie is our girl. First of all, thank you, Maddie, and all the interns and Todd for having us. We really appreciate it. They put on a flawless job of, like, making sure everything runs so smoothly. And again, like, I love that we have this round for women, like, just women, for us to show what we can do. But it's kind of sad that we have to have this just so that people will hear women. You know what I'm saying? Like, still, like, go women. I'm such a girl's girl. Oh. Oh, yeah. Hi.
We love you, Sam. Love you, Sam. You're part of this. Sam.
Honorary girl for the evening.
She's got a lot of sisters, so
honorary girl. I was raised by a very, very, very strong-headed woman. She was a farmer, and then she decided that she didn't want to be a farmer anymore. So she ended up marrying my dad, and they moved to Atlanta, where I was raised. And I got to watch my mom build a business from the ground up, which was really, really cool. Business from the ground up. And so what's even cooler about it is they sold it back in 2008. And those people ended up firing all of the employees that she had hired. And my mom was pissed. So Deborah was like, okay, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start another business with a different name and hire all those people back. And the men in that industry, it was a trash industry, were pissed. They were so mad. They were like, we don't want Deborah back in these rooms. Like, she would have men talk down to her all the time. She would come home and tell me. She had a man write her an 8-page letter about how she's too controlling, too loud, you know, whatever. But I'm sorry. Did you start a business on the ground up? No, you didn't. Okay, cool. Anyways, so this is what this is kind of about. The tagline is boys. There's a part where it says boys will be boys. And sorry. I love you guys, but I just love women so much more. I really do. I just think they can just change the world so easily without being angered, and they can build skyscrapers and they can do all these things, but for some reason we're still kind of silenced over it, and it's dumb, and we're having to have like these writers around so women can be heard, and women aren't on radio, but we're writing really fucking good songs. And so yeah, this is called Girls Can't Have Fun, and it is out everywhere. It's my favorite song ever written. Wrote it with Claire Carruthers, Julian Dawn, Emma Place, and you put four women in a room and we're gonna create something great. So here you go.
When she was five, a boy made her cry. She was told it was just 'cause he likes her. Then at 15, had to measure her seams so she didn't break dress code in high school. Turned 21, got a little too drunk, and he said, don't worry, I'll watch her. But she didn't say yes when he offered. Don't you speak out and don't you be funny. They'll forget your first name and they'll just call you honey. Keep what you're feeling all to yourself. Put your opinions up on a shelf. Cross your legs and bite your tongue. Boys will be boys, so girls can't have fun. Place at such a young age by following rules and traditions. A little more grown, she was told to stay home 'cause women work best in the kitchen. But she chose to go make a man's world her own. It didn't come without conditions. They told her just shut up and listen. You speak out and don't you be funny. They'll forget your first name and they'll just call you honey. Keep what you're feeling only yourself. Put your opinions up on the shelf. Don't you speak out. Don't you be funny, they'll forget your first name and they'll just call you honey. Keep what you're feeling all to yourself. Put your opinions up on the shelf. Hold it in like they hold their guns. Boys will be boys, so girls can have fun. You.
Y'all can follow me everywhere. I mean, not like back to my house, but like you can follow me on all my Instagrams and stuff. Brailey Lenderman. Bailey with an R. Lenderman with an E. My mom's last name. I still haven't changed it. I'm sorry, Tom.
Okay, my song is not about girls, but I'm a girl's girl and I love girls too. Sorry, guys.
I'll give it up for CashK, her very first song, Suffragettes. Come on.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you guys so much for having me.
And Sam. We love you, Sam.
And Sam. This last song that we're going to do is called Overindulged, and I released it last August, and it's about, I mean, it's kind of like a girl's girl song. It's about, like, it's about going behind someone's back. Like, okay, we broke up, and I started seeing someone else, and he got upset at me over that, but I was like, I can't feel that bad because we broke up, but, like, whatever, like, okay. Why are you hating? So, yeah, that's what this one's about. It's called Overindulged.
Real.
Overindulging on your love, you keep on pulling me closer, but I need closure. Pulling me in, this distance is giving me nothing that I want, but I want you. I can't give you my time, I'm keeping you in my side, keeping you around for when my world comes crashing down. So I'll be living two lives, one for you and my pride, the other one for another one on a late night, if it feels right, if I feel like, and that's my bad, cause I'm like that, yeah, I slide fast, but you're right back, like no time passed. And it feels like I'm overindulging on your love. You keep on pulling me closer, but I need closure. Pulling me in, this distance is giving me nothing that I want, but I want you. Cause I know that you gon' be there in the morning, know that you gon' be there when I want it. I ain't worried about you, I ain't in no hurry about you. Would you call me on a Monday? You say, Kylie, what you doing later? And we're right back where we've been at before. My stomach drops and I'm thin. You're running laps and you're big talking. We'll tell your coach to call a timeout, cause I'm worried you gon' mess around and find out that I've been running game. And babe, I can't explain why, and that's my bad, cause I'm like that, yeah, I slide fast, but you're right back, like no time passed, and it feels like I'm overindulging on your love. You keep on pulling me closer, pulling me in, this distance is giving me nothing that I want, but I want you. I'm over your love. You keep on pulling me closer, pulling me in, this distance is giving me nothing that I want, but I want you. Closer, closer, closure, closure. It's nothing that I want, but I want you. Closer, closer, closure, closure. Nothing that I want, but I want you. Thank you.
Now give it up for CashK.
Oh, and if you guys want to follow me on any of the social medias, it's at CashK, CashK. Exactly like that sounds. CashK, CashK. So nice you say it twice. Thank you guys for having me. Thank you. Thank you, listening room.
Give it up. Our very first time here at Song Suffragettes. Oh my gosh, what a beautiful voice, y'all.
Thank you.
Telling ya. We're just so grateful, like I said earlier and a million times, to be here. So thank you guys for coming out early on this Monday night. Y'all are drinking like it's Friday, though. I like you guys. I like you guys. If you've never been to a Song Suffragette show before, we have this little tradition where we close the night, we close the show with a cover tune that we all sing together. It's a really, really fun way, not only for us to all get the chance to sing together, but for you guys to sing with us a song that you'll hopefully have heard before. The host usually picks, so that would be me. It's definitely a no-pressure situation, as you can tell. But I wanted to pick a song this week that has been stuck in my head. It's by one of our favorite songwriters here from Nashville, Tennessee. We love Miss Casey Musgraves, and she just released an amazing new record called Deeper Well, so we thought we would do the title track for you guys. If you know it, feel free to sing along, y'all. This song is called Deeper Well. Thank you guys for being here.
My Saturn has returned. When I turned 27, everything started to change. Took a long time, but I learned there's two kinds of people. One is a giver, and one's always trying to take all they can take. So I'm saying goodbye to the people that I feel are real good at wasting my time. No regrets, baby, I just think.
Thanks for being here. We'll see you guys next time. Have a great night.